In this video, let's pretend we have a Productivity 3000 running an 8-lane candy bar wrapping machine with 4 lanes operational and another 4 lanes set aside for future use. The Productivity 3000 keeps track of the number of rejects on each lane, controls each lane, and has an Ethernet connection. We want this Productivity 3000 to monitor the number of rejects on each lane and have the ability to control each lane from a remote location. And we don't want to have to explicitly ask for that information. We just want it to appear here on this Productivity 3000 so we can watch and control it in real time without any hassle. Well, that's just the implicit or I/O messaging of the Ethernet IP standard, right? Where data is simply exchanged between these two automatically in the background. All we have to do is set this guy up as an Ethernet IP adapter, like we did in the adapter video, and set this guy up as a scanner, which is the focus of this video. Let's get started. Go ahead and launch the Productivity Suite software. Make sure the software version is at least 1.10.0.7. Also, make sure the firmware is up to date. Go to Pack, check Upgrade Firmware, and verify that your CPU firmware is at least 1.1.15.91. Let's see, we've already started a new project and connected with and configured the Productivity 3000 using the Auto Detect under Hardware Configuration. We're online, we're running, and we're ready to go. Now, since we're setting up the Productivity 3000 as a scanner to monitor external hardware, you would expect to find the scanner setup under Hardware Configuration. And sure enough, there it is right there. Under the Ethernet IP tab, this is where we set up the scanner. To get started, we just grab a generic client and drop it over here on the screen. It's a generic client at this point because we haven't set it up to talk to a specific device yet. Well, to set up the scanner, we just fill in the blanks. We need to give it a name. We're talking to our candy bar wrapping machine, so I'll call it CBW Scanner. Here we insert the IP address of that machine, not our current local machine, but of that candy bar wrapping machine, which I happen to know is that number right there. Let's create some tags so we can monitor the status of the connection with the adapter. We'll call these candy bar wrapper connected, candy bar wrapper name, candy bar wrapper vendor ID, and candy bar wrapper TCP error. For this video, the candy bar wrapper Productivity 3000 is very similar to the one we set up in the adapter video. Here's the dialog from that unit. I'm going to keep it on the screen so we can keep an eye on it. But just as a refresher, we had one data block with an input and an output data. We had an array to keep track of the lane rejects, and an array that would allow us to control each individual lane. On the previous video, these arrays were like, 32 elements large. On this video, we set both arrays to be 8 elements, one for each of the 8 lanes of the candy bar wrapping machine. And since only 4 of the lanes are active, instead of sending that whole array back and forth, we limited the amount of data to send back and forth to just 4 lanes to save bandwidth. Again, that was the adapter. Our job in this video is to set up the scanner. Okay, I've rearranged the screen here a little bit so that we can see the adapter and the scanner dialogs at the same time, because we're going to need some of these parameters over here in the scanner dialog. Okay, so far we've given it a name and an IP address, and created some tags so we can monitor the status of the connection with the adapter. This plus sign is where we choose the type of connected messaging we want. In the overview video, we said we could do connected messaging via explicit TCP/IP or implicit UDP. In this video, we're setting up a scanner to do implicit UDP, so we'll choose that one, and now we have a few more blanks to fill in to set up that connection. The enable. This is a bit that you'll set in your ladder logic to enable the scanner. So we'll call that CBW enable. I'm going to go ahead and fill in these tags over here so we can monitor the status of the scanner. And then once that's done, all we have to do is configure the messaging from the target to the originator. That's from the candy bar wrapper machine to us, so that's our input. And from the originator to the target, that's us to the candy bar wrapping machine, which is our output. For the data coming to us, we want that to be delivered by the adapter in a unicast, just to us. The interval between messages is currently set to 250 milliseconds. That's 4 times a second. That's plenty, I'll leave that alone. This connection point, we take that straight from the adapter. Again, this is the input data, so we go to the input block, and we see that our connection point is 101. So that's the number we put right here. Now we need to create a data array for those results to be put in. I like to use the same name as the data array that's down on the adapter, so there's no confusion. So this would be my lane rejects. Well, as soon as I click away from that, the software comes up with a dialog that says, hey, you haven't defined that lane rejects array yet. What do you want to do with that? Well, I want that to be identical to the array down here on the adapter. That was an unsigned integer 16. So I grab unsigned integer 16. I remember that he was 8 elements large. So I make my columns 8. Easy. So again, unicast, 4 messages per second. Connection point came straight from the adapter. I created a new array which looks just like the array down on the adapter. And all I have to do now is say, how many elements do I expect? Well, I know the adapter is sending 4, so I put a 4 here. And you can see the dialog's telling me that that means 8 bytes will be sent because those were 16-bit elements. Again, this was the data going from the adapter, the candy bar wrapping machine, to us. Now, to get the data in the other direction, we click on this tab and do the same thing. The timing between messages is 4 per second, every 250 milliseconds. Note that this is completely independent from the input data. I could change this rate to anything I want. The connection point for the output data is this guy right here, 102, so I put that in here. I need to create a new data array. Again, I'll call it the same thing I called it down on the adapter. And when I click away, the software reminds me I haven't created that array yet. And it says, what do you want? Well, it looks like I want an 8-bit unsigned. Let's go grab one of those. And we know we have 8 lanes, so we'll put in 8 right there. Great, the array is defined. It's 8-bit unsigned, 8-bit unsigned, perfect. Now again, only 4 of the lanes are operational. So let's put a 4 right here so that it matches the number of elements that the adapter is expecting. And since these were byte wide, that means we're only sending 4 bytes. Now here's a key point. This little checkbox that says include status header. Some adapters require a status header. Some don't. The Productivity 3000 adapter does, so we need to check that box. Now here's a trick. Suppose you're setting up a scanner with some other hardware and it doesn't have this header box. How would you tell it to send the extra 4 bytes for the Productivity 3000 adapter? Well, that's easy. You just add 4 to this. Now we're sending a total of 8 bytes down to the adapter, which is what it expects. Now we don't need to do that here, so let me change it back and add my header in. So this number plus 4 bytes here is the actual size of the data that's being sent down to the Productivity 3000 adapter. The Productivity 3000 adapter doesn't require configuration data, so I'm going to turn that off, but beware that a lot of devices do. Some of them will require configuration data even if it's zero length. So take a look at the data sheet for the device that you're talking to before you set that up. Now when we hit OK, the software says, hey, you haven't defined all these tags yet. Would you like to do that now? I love that because I don't have to predefine all my tags when I'm setting these things up. These all look great with one exception. The strings default to 15 characters. I prefer to make those strings long. That way I can handle pretty much anything that comes down the line. And we're good to go. Let's do one more thing. I want to drop back down into this candy bar wrapper scanner and hit this monitor button. What that'll do is it'll take all of these status tags and create a new tab in a data view for me. We'll label that tab candy bar wrapper scanner. Excellent. Now, could I add more scanners to talk to other devices? Sure. Let's grab more generic clients, drop them in here, fill in the blanks. I could add one for an encoder. I could add one for remote I/O. I could add one to control a VFD. You can have up to 32 of these. We don't need any right now, so I'm just going to cancel out of this. Well, that's all there is to it. Go to the Ethernet IP tab, drop a generic client in, fill in the blank so that it matches the adapter you have set up, and you're ready to go. All we have to do now is transfer this down to the PLC. Great, the transfer is done. I'm online and I'm running. Notice I have no ladder code yet. This is all being done in the background. Let's take a look at those tags that we created with the data view. Go to our candy bar wrapper scanner, and there's all those tags that we created, and here's our lane rejects and our lane control. So if I open up lane rejects, I can see them right here. That's my data view for my scanner. Here's the data view for my adapter. Now the scanner isn't running until you enable it. Remember, we created that tag that said candy bar wrapper enable. If I click on that and write it out, then sure enough, my candy bar wrapper is connected to the scanner, and I was successful at establishing communications with that adapter. So right now, data is being transferred between the adapter and the scanner in the background without me doing anything. So if I bring up the data view from the adapter, from the candy bar wrapping machine, and I change lane rejects to some other number, and write that out, then that result is reflected all the way over here in the scanner automatically in the background. Let me do that again. Keep an eye on this number right here. If I change this number to something else, let's see, our rejects went down today. Boom. that number automatically gets transferred to the scanner in the background. How sweet is that? We don't have to do anything. The scanner can simply watch that number and react to it accordingly. It doesn't have to explicitly request it from the adapter. Lane control is the exact same thing, except now that goes in the other direction, right? In lane control, we would put a new number in here, write that out, and when we do that, it automatically appears down here at the adapter. Again, we didn't have to do anything. That's the beauty of using this IO or implicit Ethernet IP messaging. This is great for real-time monitoring of Ethernet IP encoders, Ethernet IP VFDs, Ethernet IP remote IO, and other controllers that adhere to the Ethernet IP standard. And a Productivity 3000 makes it so easy. All we did was configure the hardware by dragging a generic client in here and fill in the blanks. Then in our ladder code, all we have to do is enable the scanner by toggling this Boolean value right here, and then we can go check that we actually are connected and that the connection was successful. Given that, we just drop data into the arrays and it gets transferred between the scanner and the adapter in the background automatically. How about that? Check out the other videos for specific examples of Ethernet IP encoders, VFDs, and remote I/O to see more tips and tricks using Ethernet IP on the Productivity Series controllers. If you need help, contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help you. Also, check out the forums. There are lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any questions directed at Automation Direct's tech support there. They may not see them. Performance plus value. That's productivity. From Automation Direct.